So you can't say anything about how his view on the accusations against him?
No, I cannot, because I haven't had access to him. I haven't been able to sit down and have a conversation with him. From my understanding, in the process that I was given yesterday to apply to be able to get granted access to him via phone and or via physical contact, it's probably going to be end of next week before I'm going to be able to see him or speak to him.
So what are you doing now?
Right now, I'm just communicating with our team of lawyers and counsel and working with them through the process of the courts and to evaluating what are the best next steps to release Rocky.
I mean, he has missed several shows already, and he will probably miss a few more. Can you tell us something about how this affect him cost-wise and so on?
Well, it's very damaging. He has missed a few shows, and if he's continued to be incarcerated, we're going to end up having to cancel the tour, which is going to result in multi-millions of dollars in losses. We're already into the millions, and it'll exceed well beyond that. It also will further damage, because we have recording time set aside for him when tour is finished to be able to continue recording the album. That's going to slow down that process. So it's a multitude of angles and issues that we're facing by him not being released at this time.
And what do you hope will happen now?
Well, I hope that the courts and the prosecutor kind of evaluate and see that this isn't fair, that he's being restricted. He's in solitary confinement and restricted access, and that he has full restrictions where none of us can speak to him. And B, that he's incarcerated and not in being claimed a quote-unquote flight risk, which is impossible because he's an international recording artist and his job is to tour the world and perform. So we would never put that at jeopardy. That was never an intention. We had a police escort to the police station when we voluntarily went to the police station after his concert, so there was never a question of that.
But I mean, if we talk about the incident and what is accused of, I mean, he was fighting. We can all see that in the video. But you're saying that it was self-defense. I mean, do you think it's in proportion that it's being held with this restrictions here in Sweden?
No, not at all. Especially when we were attacked, assaulted, and then harassed for a half hour over the course of four blocks, and numerous, and the videos prove this, numerous conversations, please step away. Please, we don't want an altercation. We don't want any issues. Please go away. Please go away. And a constant pursuing and constant pursuing. That is our right to be able to state that and give space. Please, you're violating space. So no, this is not proportionate at all, especially when you look at the magnitude of who he is and how this affects his touring and routing and financials. And it's not just him, it affects the whole team. It's all of us that are the crew, everyone who's a part of this tour and the show. Everything is at halt. You know, producers, engineers who are working on the album. Like this is a trickle-down effect. This is, you know, and you have to look, his calendar is visible. People can see where he is, where he's going, what he's doing. So it's easy to follow route of where we're going. The flight risk question is completely absurd to me.